I wish to offer my hearty congratulations to the Honorable the Chief Minister on the budget that he has been able to present to the House this year. No doubt the budget has been presented in a lucid manner, and the Honorable the Chief Minister has tried his best to see how the budget can be balanced with a small surplus. In spite of that, I am afraid that the budget does not stand the test of how far he has been able to give permanent relief to the poor in this state. I am afraid the Honorable the Chief Minister has adopted the policy that has been pursued in the past. The Finance Minister in the past had only one thing before them, that was to see how best the government could collect 70% of the revenues without any reference to the economic or uneconomic condition of the taxpayer. They did not take into account the fact that the condition of the agriculturist was becoming worse and worse day after day when they prepared the budget. The Honorable the Chief Minister has not taken into account the condition of the people from whom the tax is to be collected. The Honorable the Chief Minister is responsible to this house like every other minister. The government have not taken into account the condition of the people in this state, namely whether they are in a position to pay the taxes or not. I would like to ask on this occasion what measures the government are contemplating to give relief to the agriculturist. I hear that instead of giving relief to this class of people, there is going to be a measure brought forward in this house which will increase the burden of the agriculturist taxpayer in this state. I understand that the government are considering a measure called the Agricultural Income Tax Bill. I do not know how far the government are going to proceed with that measure, whether the bill will be passed in this house, whether it will be of help to the agriculturist, or whether it is going to be an additional burden on him. We know that the Honorable the Chief Minister in this budget statement has told us that a good deal is being done to give relief to the agriculturist by means of remission or some other means, and also by providing a crore of rupees to help the agriculturist by means of loans. These are very favorable so far as the agriculturist is concerned, but the burden on the agriculturist is so heavy that these small reliefs will not go a long way to help him so far as his primary needs are concerned. I therefore hope that the government will soon come forward with a measure which will regulate the land revenue in this state. The Honorable the Chief Minister in his statement has stated that government are going to borrow another sum of money. He has also stated that it will be more than what they borrowed last year. Of course, it is true that this amount that they are going to raise by way of loans is not going to be spent so far as the current needs are concerned, and that this amount is going to be set apart for capital expenditure. All the same, I am afraid that the government should not add to the burden of the taxpayer more and more by raising such loans every year. I do not know whether the government will be right in doing so. Letter from Balaji and Company, 3 Armenian Street, Madras, to Messrs. Sundaram and Company, Booksellers and Stationers, 5 South Massey Street, Madurai. Dear Sirs, We thank you for your kind inquiry of that instant. We are glad that you are interested in purchasing your requirements from us. So, we have taken special interest in giving you all the particulars that you are requiring in this connection. As you have desired, we are enclosing a list of the items of stationery that we usually supply to our customers. The prices mentioned, of course, will change from time to time, but for the present, we will be selling the items that you may require at the prices quoted in the list. We will be pleased also to sell the articles on credit basis if you are so interested. But of course, we will prefer advance payment. We are making an exception in your favor on this occasion so that you may have the opportunity of knowing the quality of the articles that we supply. As we have stated in the list, we are supplying all varieties of notebooks that may be required by the students of schools and colleges. You will notice a special feature that the list includes also items of stationery that may be required in any office. Pencils and erasers of superior quality are supplied by us. We are sure that a trial will convince you.